What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today's video is going to be nice and short and sweet, but it's going to save you from a trap that a lot of people fall into when creating grids, specifically when creating grids with utility classes. Now, you should know that I'm developing a utility class system called automatic.css. So this isn't a situation where I'm like anti-utility classes for grids or anything like that. I love utility classes for grids. In fact, automatic.css is one of the only systems that I know of that actually has automatic grid utility classes inside of it. So again, this isn't a situation where I'm like biased against utility classes for grids. It's a situation where you should absolutely not use utility classes. So we're gonna jump into the training site. I'm gonna show you what not to do, and then I'm gonna show you what to do instead, okay? So let's go ahead and hop in. Again, this is gonna save you tremendous amount of headache, struggle, strife, frustration, because you're gonna easily get yourself into a situation where you break the scalability of the site, you break the future proofing of the site, and you just put yourself in a situation where you've gotta go do a lot of manual work where you shouldn't have to do a lot of manual work, okay? All right, so I've got a testimonials card here, and I'm gonna build a grid for it the way a lot of people would do. We're gonna use utility classes, we're gonna use the automatic.css system. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit add, and we're gonna add a div. This is gonna be the wrapper for my little testimonial grid here. And I'm gonna put a class of grid 3 on this. And that's gonna give me a 3-column grid. And now because I already have the card designed, I just have to drag the card into the grid. So now the testimonial card is inside of the grid. I want you to use your imagination and just think that I've actually put a repeater in here and we're querying these from a custom post type called testimonials. And all of these testimonials are different, okay? So in reality though, in training, I'm just gonna duplicate them. So we're gonna have 6 of these testimonial cards. I'm gonna again highlight the wrapper and I'm gonna add a gap. So we're gonna do a gap of S. All right, so I've got the bones of my grid, but it's not responsive, right? Because this is not an auto grid. So if I come down, you're gonna see it starts to squish. So I have to add 2 more utility classes. One for the large breakpoint. That's gonna make it break to 2 columns. And then one for the medium breakpoint, that's where it's gonna break to 1 column. So that's super easy. We just do grid L2 and we do grid M1. So now at the L breakpoint, I have 2 columns, and at the M breakpoint, I have 1 column. So I now have a fully responsive grid. And this is why people like utility classes for creating grids. It's very quick and it's very easy. The problem is, here is a use case where we have testimonial cards, but this could be service cards, location cards, and it's a situation where we're gonna use a grid like this on maybe dozens of pages across the website. If you haven't watched my video on custom post type use cases yet, I'll link to it. Definitely go watch that. There's a lot of value in it. And you'll start building more intelligent websites where, for example, with testimonials, If a company has 10 services, we're gonna have 10 service pages. And on each one of those pages, there's gonna be a testimonial grid, except we're gonna use relationships, bidirectional relationships, to only show testimonials that are related to each service. So that when somebody's reading about service A, they see testimonials about service A, and service B has testimonials about service B. It's an intelligent way to create a site. But what that means is that we're gonna have 10 of these testimonial grids. And right now you saw me take 4 utility classes to build this grid, and this structure is now set. If I copy this to other pages on the website, and then the client says, oh, actually we want that to be 2 columns instead of 3. And actually I'd like it if the gap between those cards was a little bit bigger. Now watch what happens. I have to go to this grid manually. I have to take away the grid 3. I have to put a grid 2 on there. I have to now take away this other L2 because that's no longer necessary. I have to remove the gap S and I have to put a gap M. So now we have 2 columns and a bigger gap. But the problem is I now have to go to every other testimonial grid on the website and make those same exact changes. That is an absolute nightmare. It breaks scalability. It's not future proof. The bigger the site gets, the worse the problem gets. You have no global control over these grids when you use utility classes. So this is a situation where, like I said, you absolutely should not use utility classes for a situation like this. What should you do instead? Watch. I'm going to take away the utility classes completely. We're not going to use them for this type of use case. I am going to put a custom class on here. It's going to be called Testimonial Grid. And I am going to use the Oxygen Grid Builder. Now, if you are afraid of the Oxygen Grid Builder, I'm going to show you the ropes real quick. Okay, we're not going to dive in. This isn't a deep dive. We're just going to show you how to create the grid that I just created. And you can really make any basic grid if you know these few things. Okay, so I'm going to click the grid button here. First thing you need to understand is that when I put those utility classes on the Grid 3 class, it automatically makes that wrapper 100% width. So the first thing you can do when you put the grid on Testimonial Grid to do kind of the same effect is come down to the width area, change that to percent, and make it 100. Now your grid stretches across the entire max width of your website, okay? So now it makes it easier to work with. All right, so now I'm gonna go up and I'm just gonna control the column count. So it says right here, column count, instead of one, I'm gonna put three because we're building a three column grid. Now, unfortunately, Oxygen tries to do some of this stuff for you. It's got this minimum width and a lot of people are confused by this. Whenever you choose the number of columns, so when you explicitly tell this grid to be three columns, this number does not matter whatsoever, okay? So just delete that. Like, you don't even need it. Don't even be confused by it. Just take that number away. That number, minimum width, only matters if you're auto-fitting the columns, which we're not gonna get into. So you're gonna be setting an explicit number of columns. You're gonna take away the minimum width. You don't need that. The max width is 1FR, okay? That's one cell unit, basically. You've already told it three, so each card is gonna expand its full unit, which is 1/3, basically, okay? Don't even worry about that. That's too, like, you don't even need to know that. It's set by default. It's fine. You don't even need to change that. What you do need to change is the gap. So by default, Oxygen sets this as 20 pixels. Well, you already know probably don't use pixels, right? If you're using the automatic.css system, one thing you could do is just change this to rem, by the way, and then make it 2rem. That's equivalent. Well, we're not even going to get into that, okay? Because then we're not even going to get into that. If you're using automatic though, you can actually hook in to the spacing system in automatic. So I can change this to none and do var space M. And then I'm gonna have a spacing with gaps that perfectly matches all the other spacing on my website. All right, so that's only if you're using automatic.css. Anyway, we're gonna keep moving on. You also have to do this for the row gap. So there's a column gap that's right here running vertically, and then there's a row gap right here. Typically, you want those to be the same thing. So you have to come down and you have to go to none, and then I'm gonna paste my same variable for space M. Now the column and row spacing matches equally. All right, so I have basically, in just a couple little controls here, created the same grid that I had before, except I do have to do the responsiveness. And the responsiveness, like where it breaks it, or you know how many columns are at each breakpoint, that's where people get totally lost with this grid builder. And I'm gonna show you why. And I do agree with you, it's confusing. But once you know what's going on, it's no longer confusing, all right? And the grid builder in Oxygen is very, very powerful. It's really well done. It has some quirks. But like I said, once you understand the quirks, you're safe. You're good to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the breakpoint that I want to make the change at, less than 992. And what I have to do here is I have to click the grid button again. And then it's going to basically go back to the defaults. It's not going to remember anything that I did like you would expect it to. But if you know that it's not going to remember anything that you did and you just have to basically create a new grid at this breakpoint, you should be comfortable doing that. So I change the columns to two. I go back and paste my variables in the column gap and the row gap settings. And I don't have to worry about min width or max width on this because, again, those are irrelevant because I'm setting this as an explicit grid. So now I have a two column grid at this breakpoint. But guys, look, I'm doing this on this class. I've been doing all of this on this testimonial grid class, right? So now I'm gonna go down to the M breakpoint. I have to click the grid button again. This time the one column is good. That's exactly what I want as the default, but I still need to change the gaps. So I'm gonna go back and redo the gaps. I would really love it if it remembered the gaps from what I did on the desktop. That would be nice. It doesn't, it's a quirk. You gotta deal with it, okay? But now I have a fully responsive grid. If we save this and go to the front end, I have a fully responsive grid, looks good, boom, boom, okay? Now, what is the benefit of doing this? Well, because I built this grid on this class, I can easily replicate it anywhere across the website, and I have global control over my testimonial grids, so that when the client says, hey, you know what, we'd rather have two columns, and we'd rather the gap be a little smaller in this instance, okay? Let's just, they're making stuff up now. So all I have to do, any grid on my website, doesn't matter if I've used this 10 times or 100 times, I go to the grid, I grab the class right here, I change the column count to 2, I change the spacing to S instead of M, and I change the spacing here to S instead of M, and I've now effectively changed that grid everywhere. Now I can actually go in and delete this, the styles that were attached to this because they're redundant. And then if I go to the M class, I just change the gap here from M to S. And again, it doesn't matter if I've used this grid on 10 pages or 100 pages or 1,000 pages, the changes that I just made because I attached them to a custom class just were made everywhere. Automatically, right? That's the power of using the Oxygen Grid Builder. And the use cases would be any grid structure or use case like testimonials, services, locations, whatever, that you're going to use repeatedly throughout a website. Do not use utility classes for that. Use the Oxygen Grid Builder and attach those styles to a custom class. That is the advice that I would give you to make sure that your website is scalable and to make sure that your work that you're doing is future-proof and to avoid nightmare scenarios where you need to make a change across however many pages and it's just like manually removing and adding utility classes because everything that you did was built manually with utility classes. You don't want to be stuck in that situation. So that's basically all I've got for you guys today. I hope you found this super valuable and useful. I know that if you can avoid this trap, you're gonna like thank me later. And if you don't avoid this trap, you're gonna get stuck in this trap and wish you had known better before you got so deep into it that now you have to redo everything that you just did, all right? So that's it. Drop a like, drop a comment, hit subscribe if you aren't already subscribed, and join me in the inner circle. We just crossed 500 active members in the inner circle, and it's going absolutely fantastic there. And if you're a member of the inner circle, you get access, early bird access to automatic.css. And my inner circle is also going to get a great lifetime deal offer for automatic.css as soon as the plugin is ready. So inner circle is the place to be. I'll see you there.